Hi students, today's experiment is rectifiers. Rectifiers is nothing but it converts AC signals into pulsating DC signals. So rectifiers classified as, depending upon the period of conductions, it has half wave rectifier and full wave rectifiers. In the half wave rectifier with filter, without filter. So this is half wave rectifier without filter, and this is circuit is half wave rectifier with filter. In the with filter, extra part is only capacitor. Capacitor is connected parallel to the load. So this is half wave rectifier. The aim of this experiment is you have to plot the input and output waveforms. So output signals. This is the input waveform for half wave rectifier signal, and the output waveform will be only positive half cycle will be get. So for half wave rectifier, only diode will conduct only for positive half signals. So diode is conducts for only positive half cycle, and for negative signal it will be open. So diode will be reverse bias. So only it will conducts only for positive half cycles only. That's why you are getting in the output waveform without filter will be only positive half cycles only. For negative signals it will be zero. Again continuous signal means it is again you are getting half signals. This is output waveform for half wave rectifier without filter. So for with filter, this is the waveform. This is ripple waveform. So with filter, we are having one capacitor will be there. So for forward conduction, diode will be conducting, and we will get only positive half cycle. For reverse bias, it will be open. So it is in the forward bias, it is charging up to Vm. After that, it will be discharged by using time constant tau RC. R is we are using load resistance is 1 kilo ohm resistor, and capacitor is 100 micro farads. So for this output waveform will be with filter will be ripple voltage. We are getting ripple voltage by using a R and C values. Okay, next do the practical. So in the rectifier, we required components are diode, one diode, resistor, and transformer. Step down transformer it is, and CRO. Okay, next connect the circuit diagram as per the circuit diagram. So we require diode and resistor, transformer, CRO. So diode, this is diode. Here silver coating will be there. Silver coating of the diode side is cathode, and this is anode. Anode, cathode. Okay. So I am connecting as per circuit diagram here. Diode, anode, and cathode. From cathode to resistor. Okay. Cathode to resistor. Diode and resistor is connected in series. Okay, I am connecting series as per the circuit diagram. This is circuit diagram. From okay, this is transformer. Transformer primary is connected to the AC main, and transformer secondary terminal is connected to the input to the rectifiers, half wave rectifier. So here 909 volts will be there. So we require only 990. So only two terminals of this transformer. So I am connecting 9 is connected to the positive of anode of the diode, and cathode is connected to the resistor second end. Okay, so now start the transformer and CRO. First we have to check it input waveform. So input waveform is, I am connecting grounded here. CRO negative is connected to grounded, and positive is connected to the transformer terminal. So this is input waveform. Expected waveform also you are getting same sine wave. Your input voltage will be sine wave. That is, you are getting amplitude is 20 volts. So the number of divisions will be 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 into 5, 20 volts. V input is 20 volts for this input voltage for this circuit diagram. For next, you have to connect output. So output across resistor. So I am removing this positive terminal of the CRO and connecting it resistor and diode mode. Here resistor and diode mode. So I am getting here half wave rectifier waveform. Yes, output waveform, half wave rectifier. Here in the practical also theoretical, here in the expected waveform also same. Here whatever we are getting here practical, here also you are getting it same here. That is half wave rectifier output. Only it conducts only for positive half cycle and zero for negative half cycles. Okay, for continuous waveform. Okay, Vm you have to calculate here. Vm is nothing but what is the peak voltage from 0 to here. So now I am keeping in xy mode, we will get exact value here. So now keeping here, so it is 2 into 5 is 10 volts. Vm is 10 volts for this half wave rectifier. Okay, I am removing this one, so we will get same value, same graph. Next, we have to calculate VDC. VDC. Okay, VDC means we have to here AC and DC will be there. So you have to press it AC to DC. So it will shift it some portion. So that is ADC. Now keep it in two volts. I am referring this one is referring line. Okay, I am pressing this one. So it is shifted 1.6 into 2 is that is VDC shift. So VDC shift value will be that is VDC practical value. Practical VDC is 1.6 into 2 volts. And for theoretical value, VDC equal to Vm by pi. Vm is how much we got? 10 volts. Vm is 10 volts by pi is 3.14 volts. So you will get 3.18 volts. This is theoretical value. So 1.6 practical VDC, practical is VDC shift. How much? 1.6 into 2. So we will get 3.2 volts. So approximately theoretically, practical is VDC is approximately equal. So now we have to calculate VRMS. VRMS is Vm by 2. That is Vm is 10 volts by 2 is you will get 5 volts VRMS. Next we have to calculate VRRMS. By theoretically here formula will be VRMS square minus VDC square. So here we got VRMS. VRMS is 5 volts. So that is 5 square minus VDC is 3.18. Or we can take 3.2, you can get any one. So 3.18 I am taking here. So 5 square minus 3.18 square. So you will get VDC VRMS equal to 3.858 volts. Okay. Next we have to calculate ripple factor of half wave rectifier. The ripple factor formula will be VRRMS by VDC. VRRMS, how much you got? 3.858 volts. By VDC is how much? 3.18 volts. So we will get ripple factor will be 1.21. So ripple factor will be 1.21. In percentage, you will get 121% into 100. So you will get 121%. Half wave rectifier ripple factor will be 121%. This is without filter. Now we have to go for with filter. In the with filter, what is the form circuit diagram? Here only capacitor is connected parallel to the load resistor. So capacitor is, I am taking 100 microfarad. It is 100 microfarad capacitor. So here length of the terminal is positive and shorter one is negative. So I am connecting as per circuit diagram here. Capacitor is parallel to the resistor. I am connecting parallel to the resistor. Okay. So I am getting here ripple voltage. That is here excited graph will be like this. With filter graph will be ripple voltage. So I am getting also here approximately ripple voltage. It is ripple voltage triangular waveform approximately. Okay. This voltage will be VR. So this peak to peak voltage is VR. So keep it in xy mode, you will get exact value, that is 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, 0.8 into 2, that is VR, okay, that is VR. So Vm is already known, that is 10 volts, same as half a rectifier without filter. So VR is now 0.8 into 2, that is 1.6 volts, VR is 1.6 volts. Now VDC theoretical is formula will be Vm minus VR by 2 volts. Vm is 10 volts minus VR is 1.6 by 2. So we will get how much value? So 9.2 volts. VDC theoretical it is. VDC practical. VDC practical is here to reference, you have to take it in one line here. I am taking this reference line and convert AC to DC. So I am taking this is reference line. So keep it in xy mode. So you will get exact value. So how much it is shifted? That is VDC shift. So from here to it is shifted here. Check it now. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 4.2. So 4.2, VDC shift is 4.2. So 4.2 into, so VDC shift plus VR by 2, VDC practical formula will be VDC shift plus VR by 2 into poles, that is 4.2 into 2 plus VR is already known 1.6, so 1.6 by 2. So we will get value will be 4.2 into 2, 8.4 plus 0.8. So you will get 9.2 volts. Practical and approximately equal. So theoretical and practical will be same here. Okay. Next go for VR RMS formula. VR RMS formula is VR by 2 root 3. For with filter, VR RMS is VR by 2 root 3. Without filter, VR RMS is equal to VR RMS square minus VDC square. So VR is how much we got? Here already we got 1.6 volts by 2 into root 3. If you calculate, its value will be VRM is equal to 0.461 volts. So VRM is equal to 0.461 volts. Next, you have to calculate ripple factor. This is practical value. VRRMS by VDC. VRRMS by VDC is VRMS we got 0.461 volts. VDC is 9.2 volts. So we will get 0.05. Here in the percentage you will get 5%. This is practical. So theoretical formula will be ripple factor theoretical is 1 by 2 into root 3 into F into C into RL. Here we are taking F is 50 hertz. For AC voltage any value you will get only 50 volt hertz. And the capacitor I have used 100 microfarad and resistor is 1 kilo ohm resistor. So 2 into 3 into F is 50. See, capacitor is 100 microfarad and resistor is 1 kilo ohm resistor. So if you calculate it, you will get 0.057 value. So practical and theoretical is same, approximately. Theoretical practical is 0.05 and theoretical is 0.057 volts. Sorry, 0.05 value. That is approximately 5%. So here practical and theoretical ripple factor will be 5%. And ripple factor is for without filter 1.21, that is 121%. Okay, next to go for full wave rectifier. So full wave rectifier circuit diagram will be this one. Here we are required two diodes, an adapter transformer you are using, and one resistor. Without, this is for without filter full wave rectifier. Okay, here for positive signal D1 is conduct, for negative cycle D2 is conducting. That's why you are getting total full wave rectifier. Here for positive signal D1 is conducting, for negative signal D2 is conducting. So we are getting total full wave rectifier. It is continuous waveform. So here in the with filter we are using capacitor in parallel with load resistor. So in the load resistor capacitor will charge for VM, it is charging to up to VM, after that it will be discharging for negative cycle. For positive signal capacitor will be charging, for negative signal it will be discharging. Charging, discharging, depends upon tau value, it will be, this charging and discharging value will be depending upon tau value. Tau equal to RC, okay. This is ripple voltage. This is with filter. This is without filter or waveform. And this is for with filter waveforms, okay. Next to go to the practical connections. So we are required two diodes, one center tap transformer, load resistor. This is for without filter full wave rectifier with the center tap transformer. So, okay. So two diodes I am using. So okay, one diode and second diode is anode is, and both cathodes are connected in same node. So I am connecting same node here. So cathode connected in same node. So both cathode to one resistor. I am connecting one resistor to, that is 1 kilo ohm resistor load. Load to, I am connecting one, I am taking this as ground. So taking this one resistor and transformer here, center tap transformer having 909 volts. So first 9 volts is connecting to the first diode D1, and second 9 volts is connected to the second diode, that is D2, and 0 middle one connection is connected to the ground. So that is resistor second terminal. So output is across CRO. So output positive is connected to the both cathode diode and resistor terminal and negative is connected to the grounded. Okay, this is full wave rectifier output waveform. So input voltage is same as half wave rectifier, that is input voltage, that is total sine wave signal, that is Vm is peak to peak voltage is 20 volts, Vm is 10 volts. I am getting here full wave rectifier output also 2 units into 5, that is 10 volts. Vm is 10 volts. So I am writing here full wave rectifier Vm is 10 volts. Next to VDC theoretically is formula is 2 Vm by pi. 2 Vm by pi means 2 into 10 by pi is 3.14. Or that is you will get, this is 20 by 3.14, so you get 6.366 volts, that is VDC theoretical value. VDC practical is how much you have to calculate, you have to shift in to AC to DC converting. Now this is reference line, so keep it in experiment, you will get it that, and converting AC to DC. So I am repeating this one. So now AC DC will be there. Shifting, pressing this AC to DC, it will be shifted to 1, 2, 3. So exactly you have to check it. 1, 2, 3, 3.1. So it will be between 3 and 0.2. It will be so it is 3.1. 3.1 into 2. So it will 6.4. So VDC shift is 3.1 into 2, that is 6.2 volts. So approximately theoretical and practical will be same. Okay, remove X-ray mode, you will get exact half wave rectifier waveform. Next to go to the calculation of VRMS. VRMS is Vm by root 2. Vm by root 2 is Vm is 10 volts by root 2 is 1.414, that is value this. So you will get 7.07 volts. So VRMS equal to VRMS square minus VDC square. So formula will be VRMS square minus VDC square. VRMS is 7.07 volts whole square minus VDC is how much, you got 6.366 volts whole square. So we will get 3.07 volts. So from this we have to calculate ripple factor. Ripple factor formula will be VRRMS by VDC. VRRMS is 3.07 by VDC is how much? 6.366. So you will get 0.4483. In the percentage you will get 48%. If you multiply with 100, you will get 48%. That is full wave rectifier without filter, ripple factor will be 48%. So next to go to the full wave rectifier with filter. So with filter means you have to add one capacitor in parallel to the resistor. You have to connect one resistor, capacitor, that is 100 microfarad connected to the so you are getting ripple voltage here. So ripple voltage is this is that is here, but the model graph also same, ripple voltage is triangular waveform. Proximal triangle, so you are getting same triangular waveform. Okay, so this value will be VR, peak to peak voltage is VR. Okay, so this peak to peak voltage is VR, so keep it in X-ray mode, you will get exact value, that is 0.4. So 0.2, 0.4, subdivision will be there, 0.2, 0.4, 0.4 into 2, that is 0.4. 0.4 into 2, 0.8 volts. So Vm is 10 volts, already known. Vr is 0.4 into 2 volts, that is 0.8 volts. So VDC theoretically this formula will be Vm minus Vr by 2. Vm is 10 volts minus Vr is 0.8 by 2. So 10 minus 0.4, that is 9.6 volts. So 10 minus 0.4 is 9.6 volts. For VDC practical, VDC practical formula will be VDC shift to plus VR by 2. Here VDC shift to plus VR by 2, which is by 2. So you have to shift it to within 5 volts. Here you will get exact sum. So I am pressing to reference this one. So it is shifted to 1.8. So 1, 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, 0.8, 1.8 into 5, 1.8 into 5 plus VR by 2, VR is 0.8 by 2. So 1.8 into 5 is 9 volts, 9 plus this is 0.4, so you will get 9.4 volts. So approximately theoretical and practical will be same. 9.6 is for theoretical, 9.4 for practical VDC. So next we go to the VRRMS. VRRMS formula will be VR by 4 root 3. This is V with filter. Without filter is under root VRMS square minus VDC square. So VR is how much we got? 0.8. 0.8 by 4 into root 3. So we will get 0.1154. It is VRRMS. Next go to calculate practical VR, ripple factor. Ripple factor practically, the formula will be VRRMS by VDC. VRRMS value will be 0.1154 and VDC is, so how much get VDC theoretical? 9.6 volts. So you will get 0.012. In the percentage you will get 1.2% into 100. Okay, this is ripple factor for practical value. Theoretical formula will be 1 by 4 into root 3 into F into C into RL. 1 by 4 root 3. F is for AC signal 50 hertz. 50 into F is I am using 100 microfarad and capacitor is 100 microfarad. Resistor is 1 kilo ohm resistor. F is 50 hertz. So 1 by 4 into root 3 F into F equal to 50. C is 100 micro. RL is 1K. So you will get 0.028. 0.028. Ripple factor theoretical and practical approximately equal. So 0.012, 0.028. Okay. Next go to the full wave rectifier with bridge rectifier. Full wave bridge rectifier. So in the bridge rectifier you are required four diodes. Four diodes, that is D1, D2, D3, D4. And you are using 90 volts. The transformer is using only 901. In that before you are using center diode transformer, here you are using normal transformer, okay, and here required one resistor and CRO. This is without filter. With filter you are using same, previously you are using whatever is that, in the parallel to the resistor you are using capacitor. You have to connect capacitor in parallel to the load resistor, that is 100 microfarad. So bridge rectifier, you have to connect bridge rectifier as per circuit diagram here. So I am doing this one and connect as per circuit diagram. So we have required four diodes for bridge rectifier. Okay, so anode, I am connecting here anode to anode cathode. Again, second D2 anode, so D4 I am connecting here cathode. And D2 cathode and D4, D2 cathode and D3 anode, same mode. So D2 cathode, D4 anode. Okay. Next to D1, D3. So D4 cathode, D1 anode. D4 cathode, D1 anode. And D1 cathode is connected to the D3 cathode. D3 cathode. Okay, this is bridge rectifier. So four diodes are connected as bridge type, that is called as bridge rectifier. So here in the transformer you are using 9 volts to D4 D2 terminals, D1 terminals, 9 here, and 0 transformer middle terminal is connected to the D2 D3 terminal. Okay. D2 digital mode. Okay. Next to load resistor is connected to the from D1 and D3 node. I am connecting to the not somewhere node. I am connecting here. And D4 D2 terminal is connected to the load resistor load second terminal. Okay, this is circuit diagram. Next, you have to connect output is CRO probe is connected to the resistor across resistor. So across resistor. So we will get full wave rectifier output form. So keep it in XY mode, you are getting full wave form. Okay. So that is value will be Vm is 1 to 2 into 5, 10 volts. Keep it in XY mode, you will get exact value. This is 1 to 2 into 5, 10 volts. This is full wave rectifier, bridge rectifier. So you have to calculate same as full wave rectifier in the center tapped formula. Vm is 10 volts here. Vdc is 2 Vm by pi formula. 2 into Vm is 10 by pi is 3.14. So you get 20 by 3.14. So 6.366 volts. So this is theoretical. Practically, you have to keep it in XY mode. So you have to XY mode. So 1.2. Referencing, this is reference line. From here to it is shifted to here. So keep it in XY mode, you will get exact value. Zooming. So here to 1.2 into 5. 1.2 into 5. 6 volts approximately equal. Practical and theoretical. Next to calculate VRMS. VRMS is Vm by root 2. Vm is 10. 10 by root 2. So we will get 7.07 volts. Next to calculate VRRMS. VRMS formula will be under root VRMS square minus VDC square. VRMS square is 7.07 volts whole square minus VDC square is 6 volts, 6.366 volts. So you will get 3.07 volts. Next we have to calculate ripple factor. Ripple factor formula will be VRRMS by VDC. VRRMS is you got 3.07 volts, VDC is 6.3666 volts. So you will get 0.483. Same as center tapped transformer, full wave rectifier, bridge rectifier and center tapped, you will get same value, that is 4.483. In the percentage you will get 48%. Okay. Next to go to the width filter. In width filter you have to connect same circuit, parallel you have to connect one capacitor. Okay, I am connecting capacitor to the node. Capacitor parallel to the resistor. Positive node is connected here and negative is connected to the second end of the resistor. So I am connecting here to here. This is capacitor output. So keep it in. You will get, this is ripple voltage filter output. Okay, this value will be VR peak to peak. VR peak to peak is how much value? 0.4 into 2. That is VR peak to peak voltage. So Vm is same as that is 10 volts constant, and VR is 0.4 into 2 volts, that is 0.8 volts. So VDC theoretical is Vm minus VR by 2. Vm is 10 minus VR is 0.8 by 2. So you will get 10 minus 0.4. So you will get 9.6 volts. Next to go to the practical. So VDC practical is, you have to reference one node, you have to take it reference and multiply with, you have to shift in. I am refreshing this one. Shifting this one, or you have to keep it in 5 volts. X, keep it in XY mode, you will get exact value. So it is shifted to 1.8. 1.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8. 1.8 into 5. That is VDC shift. 1.8 into 5. Okay. 1.8 into 5. Plus VR is already got 0.8 by 2. So formula VDC practical is VDC shift plus VR by 2. Theoretical Vm minus VR by 2. So it is 9 plus 0.4. So 9.4 4 volts. Approximately equal. 9.6 is 9.4 volts. Next, you have to calculate VRRMS. VRRMS is VR is 0.8 by 4 into root 3. So we will get 0.1154 volts. So this is VRRMS. The repeat factor for practical. The repeat factor formula for practical will be VRRMS by VDC. VRRMS VDC VDC is 0.1154 by VDC is 9.6 volts. So you will get point. Ripple factor will be 1.012 in percentage, 1.2%. So in the theoretical formula will be 1 by 4 root 3 into FC into RL for ripple factor theoretical. So you get here FE is 50 hertz, capacitor is 100 microfarad, resistor is 1 kilo ohm resistor. So if you calculate it, you will get 0.028. 0.012 is 0.02, approximately equal. Okay, so this graph will be same, this one. So here in the bridge rectifier and full wave rectifier, values will be same. Values will be ripple factor is 48%, in the here also 4.483, here also 4.483, in percentage 48%, 48%. In full wave with filter, ripple factor is 0.012, 0.012, percentage is 1.2. So values will be same, but here we are using in the full wave rectifier, center diode transformer we are using, in the full bridge rectifier we are using extra two diodes, we are using two extra two diodes. So total four diodes, we are using two diodes and center diode. So here using normal transformer, step down transformer and two diodes only. So main feedback of full wave rectifier is in the center diode, center diode transformer is high cost. In the bridge rectifier, diodes will be very low cost. So that's why we are preferring bridge full wave rectifier. Okay, thank you.